Bismillah, walhamdulillah. My dear sisters and my brothers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, and welcome to another Under 9 Minutes series about crystal healing. And I would like to say that humans have discovered since a long time ago that they are the only ones that can differentiate between the mind, the body, and the soul. And when they did, a whole new set of philosophies exploded and came to the being. These philosophies started simple at first, but then they got complicated, and so many concepts were built upon these. What do I really mean by saying that? Well, whenever you hear this combination of the mind, body, and soul, or in any of its forms, they all are talking about creating a certain harmony and balance between the three essential parts of the human being. Allah spoke about this harmony in countless parts in the Quran, and He usually refers to them as as-sam'a wal-absara wal-af'ida, translated into the hearing, the seeing, and the comprehension or the understanding. And Allah is not just talking about giving us ears to listen to things, or eyes to look at things, or a heart that we feel certain things, or just a heart that pumps blood. The truth is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala laid down the truth right in front of our very eyes in far more deeper and more important ways. And since He is the one who created us, He is also the one that counted the great gifts that He has given us. He equipped us as humans with so many beautiful things. At the top shelf of those beautiful things is as-sama, al-absar, and al-af'ida. As-sama, the hearing, is not to hear with the ears. You see, what is more important than perceiving, just listening to somebody, but is actually what you make out of what you just heard. And what you can perceive through vision, both physical vision and emotional vision through your guts and spiritual mind. Then comes the feelings that Allah has given us, the heart and the soul. Throughout the Quran, Allah spoke about how wonderful when the three elements are in harmony, when they are in synchronicity with each other, what beautiful world a person will lead. You see, hearing, you can hear with your ears, but so many times you listen to somebody talking, but you choose to ignore them, even though the ability of listening is present, but the comprehension after the listening is not. But Allah is telling us far more than just hearing, because we share the hearing with cats and animals. We all hear, but it is what we do with that hearing that differentiates us with other creatures. We are creatures of hormones, and by that I mean those hormones that are chemical substances that exist in our bodies. And these hormones, or those chemical substances, they affect every part of our body. To keep things simple, in essence, hormones serve as messengers. They are the way the brain communicates with the entire body and how the entire body communicates with the mind. You get hungry, your body requests food through hormones, and your mind answers back through hormones. You get hungry, a hormone is sent to the mind. The mind responds back and sends another hormone to put eating or seeking food into execution. Everything is done through hormones. You are angry. Too many anger hormones inside you. You need to counter their existence with happy hormones. If you are in love, your body will secrete, will provide, will produce too many hormones inside your love hormones. Sexually aroused, the same thing, too many sex hormones are inside you. And the more you think about sex, the more hormones are produced, the more excited your body gets. And then the body responds accordingly with that signals that you send them through hormones. If you listen to a sad song, The body produces sad hormones. All that is because you've heard, you've used the faculty or the perception of listening, and suddenly your body responds differently. Hormones can be produced, my sisters and my brothers, through physical or emotional factors. The physical factors, you get cold, that's physical. Your body produces, I need to get warm hormones, and then sends them to the brain. The brain understands this command, and he responds back to the body, get warm. And then the body looks around, and then you get warm in a different of way. Sometimes you add a sweater. But all what you do is a question answer that takes place within you, and the carrier of these question and answers are hormones. If in the world of technology today, you listening to my voice right now is done through your phone or your computer, then your phone and your computer or your computer are the hormones that carry my message, my vocal message to your earring. As for the emotional ones, you get scared. That's an emotional. Your body produces, I am scared hormones. The brain understands the message, then sends a message back to the rest of the body by creating scare hormones, ordering the body to show symptoms of fear. A kid cries, you cannot sleep at night, you leave the lights on. All these are in response to hormones. There are times, however, in our quest to becoming the advanced species that Allah wanted us to be. You see, when Allah created a cat, the cat has always, for millions of years, behaved the way it behaves today. We humans, since Allah broke our link with the past humans that were before us, and since He turned us into these beautiful humans that we are, starting from our father, Adam alayhi salam, we humans keep evolving day after day. Subhanallah, we made iron talk, we made wood talk, we did what we did, we invented, we flew in the airs, we went deep in the oceans, and Allah, we changed hearts. This was not given to any other species but us humans. Some of these experiments were done through researches, while others experiments just happened like that. We don't know. Somebody was looking for something, and then they ended up on a result. They found out something else. They were not looking for it. And so many discoveries were made, just like this one here. There once was a time when humans didn't even know of the existence of fire. Would you believe that? Allah tells us this in the Quran. There was once a time when we humans didn't know what fire was. We never heard of it, never seen it, and never ever it did exist right in front of our very eyes. I'm coming up to the 9 minutes, so I'm going to stop here and invite you to carry on listening to part two, which is the full talk, to get a better understanding about crystal healing. So I also will speak about how Allah spoke about that in the Quran, the warnings and everything. So the rest of it is in part two. I invite you please to go and listen to it. There is a lot that I cover there, a lot of grounds about the crystals and how Allah has dealt with this issue and why Muslim we should never ever cross that barrier. Again, this is your brother Abdusalam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.